Mike Kavanaugh from HERONEWS.ORG and HERONEWS.ORG, and I'm here with the amazing, amazingly talented Tyner Dumortier. How are you?
Wonderful. Thank you for having me.
Are you kidding? You are our Broadway hero for January. Start the new year. And thank you so much. You did our benefit for Broadway and Ballet this year. So you are amazing.
Thank you so much. It was a pleasure to be part of that.
So tell me, where are you from?
That's a story in itself. I was born in Nashville, Tennessee. And I was raised in the south of France. My father is French and my mother is American. So at the age of 8 years old, we moved back to Kentucky, Western Kentucky, where my mother's family's from. That's where I began dancing. And from there, then I traveled back to France to study at a conservatory in Nice for a year, and then finished out my studies at Nashville School of the Arts, which is a public arts high school there. And from there, then I ended up going to Rutgers University in New Jersey for their dance program, and that's how I ended up in New York and dancing for the past 5 years.
So what's kind of amazing is people don't think of Rutgers as a dance school, but you got a scholarship. Tell us about that. Why is that so cool?
Well, it was wonderful. I was very blessed to get a scholarship to the dance program. Story is, I was a junior in high school at Nashville School of the Arts, and I went to a festival called the National High School Dance Festival. It's for public arts high schools in the United States, and once a year they have a big festival where you go and you take classes from different teachers from all these different programs, and there are also scholarship auditions for seniors. It's a recruitment for different programs and conservatories and universities throughout the nation. Based on my audition in Miami, at the audition, I had been accepted into the dance program. And when I was flying around and going to different colleges and auditioning, Rutgers was the last one that I went to. And I did the scholarship audition, and I fell in love with the studios, the faculty, just the area. It was wonderful, and just I felt that was the place that I needed to go.
That's pretty amazing. So tell me, what is it about dance that makes you so happy?
Well, that's kind of it. It's something that makes me happy, and I love to do it, and I do what I love. I wake up every morning, and I'm so blessed and thankful that I get to dance, to express myself, to be in the studio with these amazing artists, and that continue to challenge me and enhance myself as a dancer and also as an artist, and get to meet all these people that I work with. There's different choreographers and different experiences and projects, and like Broadway Ballet and all the people that I met there, and the performances that I got to see, and all these different artists. It was an amazing experience, and so I dance because it makes me happy.
Tell me why it seems, confessing all of my dreams, should be the hardest journey I can see. Give me time.
When did you realize you wanted to be a dancer?
I was 13 years old, and I was in Kentucky at the time, and my father had the French News Channel, and they were doing a documentary on the Paris Opera Ballet, and it was going through a two-hour special on the students and how they start, and the training and the pre-professional studies all the way through the company and the principal dancers, and I fell in love with what these students, what these dancers, artists, how they invested themselves, and I was just glued to the TV for 2 hours. And I remember it was a commercial break. I turned around to my parents and said, "That's what I want to do." And I feel like for me, that was just kind of the pivotal moment that I was like, I know that's what I want to do, and I'm going to do it. And I was thankful that my parents were very supportive and found opportunities for me to pursue my passion.
So tell us about Ten Hairy Legs. So you're one of the founding members, and it's an amazing dance troupe. So what are your plans, and what are you going to be up to?
I am one of the founding members, along with four other men, three of which I graduated from Rutgers University with. And what are we up to? We're going into our fourth season. We are a repertory company, so we bring in a lot of different choreographers to either create work on us or set existing work that they have already created for their own companies or their own respective projects. And we also, of course, have our artistic director, Randy James, who creates work on us, and we have past work that we have created with him and other work that he's created before us that he then sets on us. So it's always changing. It depends on the season. It depends on what choreographies we bring in. But I'm very thankful to have that experience in a repertory company because I'm not just doing the work of one single person. So every time that I'm in a studio with a new choreographer, it's like a new flavor, it's a new style of movement. There's always something to learn and something to gain, and I love that challenge of really making myself a blank slate. And I am the dancer who I am, but I'm also going to try and take on whatever it is, like the emotionality or the choreography or the way of movement, you know, the intricacies of how they move. So it's always challenging myself as a dancer. Yeah, and I love that.
So Tyner, tell me something quirky about you.
Quirky about me. I love to clean. Yeah.
Okay. You were just in my apartment. Would you like to come clean my apartment?
Absolutely. I'm more than happy to help. It's very funny. I find it therapeutic. A lot of the times I think the most or more clearly, when I'm multitasking, and I love a clean space. I guess, you know, I'm a dancer, I'm all about space, and if my space, my apartment is not organized, I don't feel that I can think clearly. Of course, there's times where I'm just laying on the couch with a bag of potato chips, and I just don't care, you know, and I'm totally fine with that. But a lot of the times, I like to clean because I feel like I'm accomplishing something, you know, and at the same time, I feel like I'm organizing the space around me, and it allows me to think more clearly, and I feel comfortable in my space when it's...
I just want to mention that he was a featured performer at Broadway and Ballet, our first ever gala, and he did this amazing piece with his roommate, Alex. When all you're searching is right where you are. This love will last all eternity.
Confident about what you can offer, but also be able to take in information, whether it be rejection, constructive criticism, or compliments. You know, they're all in the same. You can all grow from them. So, yes, always be nice. Never burn a bridge. Yeah. It's a very small world.
Doing charity work so important to you, and why is the fight against AIDS very important to you?
It's important to give back, and I felt that I could give back by performing and sharing my love of dance and hopefully inspiring others to dance, or just the pure enjoyment of watching these bodies on stage. And I felt like that's what I could give, and so I was happy to be able to share that with you and share that with everyone that was there and for this, you know, amazing organization. Yeah. Someday I'll reach upon the sky, wake up where the clouds are.
Thank you. Tyner, as you know, we're a site for newly diagnosed people living with HIV. Do you have a message about the importance of safe sex practices, especially for young people like you and people in the arts?
Yes, always play it safe. You know, it just takes that one time. And so don't be a fool, wrap your tool.
Oh my God, that could be our new slogan. Our slogan is condoms are hot. Do you think condoms are hot?
They are very hot.
Say it.
Condoms are hot.
So, Tyner, I want to thank you so much for being our Broadway Hero of the Month and starting out the new year, because you're so talented and you've done so much for our event, Broadway and Ballet, and you're going to be with us again this year. So, really want to support you and everything you're doing. And 10 Hairy Legs, where can we find out about 10 Hairy Legs?
You can go to 10hl.org, and you can also visit the other company that I dance for, Svee Dance. And that's svdance.com. So check us out.
Okay. Well, listen, thank you so much. And you're an amazing addition to our Broadway Heroes of the Month. You're an amazing guy. And I truly, truly thank you.
Thank you so much for having me. It was a pleasure to be a part of the first awards. And I look forward to this year, to be on stage and, you know, helping this organization. Hello, my name is Tyner Dumortier, and I'm so thankful to be the Broadway Hero of the Month. Please check out the dance companies that I perform for, 10 Hairy Legs, it's 10hl.org, and Svee Dance at sveedance.com. I look forward to performing and seeing everyone at the upcoming Hero Awards in October. Thank you so much, and have a wonderful new year.